concludes the oral questions.
There are a total of 4 members' motions for today's meeting. First member's motion, proposed resolution under the interpretation and general clauses ordinance to extend the period for amending the public health and municipal services ordinance, public pleasure grounds amendment of 4th schedule number 2, order 2012. And now I call upon Honourable Andrew Leung to speak and move the motion. Mr. Leung. President, on the 12th of October 2012, House Committee meeting, members decided to set up a subcommittee to look into the Public Health and Municipal Services Ordinance, Public Pleasure Grounds Amendment of 4th Schedule Number 2, Order 2012. Members agreed that in my capacity as Chairman of the House Committee, I move a motion to extend the period of scrutiny to November the 7th, 2012, so the subcommittee will have sufficient time to scrutinize the order. President, all the details set out in the order paper, I urge members to support the motion. Does any member wish to speak? Ms. Sitho? President, I pushed the button to speak, but I couldn't get the button to work. President, this extension of the scrutiny of the Public Health and Municipal Services Ordinance, Public Pleasure Grounds Amendment of 4th Schedule Number 2, Order 2012, was moved by me. So I'd like to go on the record to mention the rationale of seeking an extension. Now, in the promenade of the WKCD, the management will be transferred from the LCSD to the WKCDA. Now, in transferring the management authority, we have to seek clarification that the two authorities, LCSD and the WKCDA, whether there would be any changes to the culture of management. I understand that the LCSD has inherited from the former municipal councils very outdated management rules. In these rules, the utilization of the facilities would be very, very restricted. Like, for instance, people are not supposed to lie on the lawn if you want to sunbathe on the lawn. I mean, it is prohibited. Also, in the parks, you're not supposed to sing to play musical instruments unless you have a permit issued, which is very cumbersome. Now, we are promoting the WKCD for use by the public. We are promoting the development of local cultural scene. These restrictions run counter to all these ideas. We asked the WKCDA as to whether in managing these facilities they would inherit all these outmolded, restrictive LCSD rules. Now, the WKCDA chief executive said that they would not. They would allow freedom for the public to express themselves, to exercise their artistic freedom. My question is to ask WKCDA whether, upon taking over the facilities, how will they exercise management, or will they be just managing the facilities in accordance with the rules of the LCSD, or will they be anything new to make sure that there would be free use of the facilities and to get rid of the restrictive, outmolded LCSD or municipal council rules and regulations? If this is the case, then what is the legislative framework going to be? So I proposed that this subcommittee be set up so that we, within the short period of time, we can seek clarifications from the authorities. And we hope that the members of the public and those who are concerned about cultural development will have a happy reply. Does any other member wish to speak? Ms. Andrew Leung? I now put a question to you, and that is that the motion moved by Honourable Andrew Leung be passed. Will those in favour please raise their hands? Those against? I think the question is agreed by a majority of each of the two groups of members who are present. I declare the motion passed.
第二及